race, can't none of y'all beat me. Boy, I'm so good, it feel like I'm cheating. A well of the storm, I feel like a season. This type of genius, I get you some sign and have your own sneaker. I'm in the band, I'm pushing the meter. A legend like John for everyday people. I got the heart of a champion. I got the blood of a winner. I don't know how to be stagnant. I got way too much ambition. I keep on beating statistics. How would I be denied? My only option is winning. I'm crossing. I put myself in a place where nothing can top me. I feel like I'm space. It's bigger than profit, but still I get paid. My thinking colossal, not minimum wage. Talk to the lost like I know the way. Stay on my job like who need a break? It was impossible, I heard them say. But I'm like MacGyver to all my mistakes. Running back home, now look at the bases. Been winning so long, I feel like a native. I got what you want, but you cannot take it. I do what you don't, cause I'm a creator. I put me on, no help for your favors. I'm breaking the mold to show you the flavors. I got control, you can't enable. I'm using my flaws to make me the greatest. I'm number one, I'm number one. I'm number one, yeah. I'm number one, I'm number one. I'm number one, I'm number one. I'm number one, yeah. I'm number one, I'm number one.
It's more than just breathing and staying alive. All that I feel is a fire inside. I have outrun it. It's a new dawn, it's a new day. Some things are different, but nothing is changed. Still got my number, still got my name. Tell everybody I'm back in the game. This is my time, faster than ever, hungry and I'm going to come back and take what is mine, bigger and better. It's a new dawn, it's a new day, some things are different but nothing is changed. Still got my number, still got my name, tell everybody I'm back in the game. I need somebody who stays in one place, ready to go, I'm coming to play. You better know I still got something to say. It's a new dawn, it's a new day. Some things are different, but nothing has changed. Still got my number, still got my name. Tell everybody I'm back in the game.
They just want you for your spot. Now they think you forgot. All the times you was down bad and they laughed at you. Now you up, now they mad at you. Taking shots, throwing jabs at you. Observing the game, I'm watching the field. Ay, you either fake or you real. Never been fan of the snakes. Lie to your back and smile on your face. No, it's not up for debate. Gotta be you if you wanna be great. Gotta stay true through all of the hate. Eyes on the prize, no time for the fake. Step it up, now step it up. I had to know how to step it up. Back in the day, I was regular. No one was helping us. I had to stick to a schedule. I had to put in the work. I had to show them just what I was worth. Show them the hate didn't work. The snakes, they was lurking and plotting. They thought I would fail. But I stayed focused and stayed on my mission. And look, I prevailed. The shit finally sailed. It was a blessing. No losses, but lessons. Now I'm sending a message that if you want it, go and get it. Give your haters an honorable mention. Observing the game and watching the field. You either fake or you real. Never been fan of the snakes. Lie to your back and smile on your face. No, it's not up for debate. Gotta be you if you wanna be great. Gotta stay true through all of the hate. Eyes on the prize, no time for the fake.
Snakes in the grass, gotta cut them. Anything not the fam, I don't trust them. You know I gotta eat, I gotta hustle. Pulling on my weight, I flex my muscle. Snakes in the grass, gotta cut them. I'm
Whether you're building your dream home, buying a fixer-upper, or downsizing, the process can feel overwhelming. Let the local team at Lighthouse Title help the closing process be one less worry. Just ask your real estate professional or lender to close at Lighthouse Title. To learn more about how we're involved in our 35 communities or to ask us any questions about the process, visit us online at lighthousetitle.net.
Gentlemen, and welcome to DeVos Fieldhouse for tonight's matchup between the Hope College Flying Dutch and the St. Mary's Bells. A midweek MIAA matchup between these two teams. As we take a look at the starting lineups for the Bells tonight, guard Kate Restovich, forward Mary Kate Garreau, guard Annie Restovich, guard Nicole Conley, and forward Athena Sampson. One of the storylines tonight are the two sister guard duos for the Bells have had great years so far for them. Annie and Kate Restovich out of Wildwood, Missouri, will definitely be a force to watch tonight on the court. As we take a look at the Hope College Flying Dutch starting lineup, a lot of familiar faces that we have seen all year. Sydney Viss, Jada Gardner, Raven Jemison, Carson Carbloom, and Keegan Kaiser will get things started for the Flying Dutch tonight as they will lead the way. But as we know, we have seen all year from the Flying Dutch, head coach Brian Morehouse is going to cycle in many players throughout the night. So it'll definitely be an exciting matchup we have on our hands. We're going to step away for just a moment for the national anthem and starting lineups for tonight's game from the one and only Darren Dijstemars.
Ladies and gentlemen, at this time, if able, we ask you to please rise. Ladies and gentlemen, to honor America with the singing of our national anthem, please welcome Hope College freshman, Mr. Kyle Spiegel.
Oh, say can you see by the dawn's early light what so proudly we hailed at the twilight's last gleaming, whose broad stripes and bright stars through the perilous fight, o'er the ramparts we watched, were so gallantly streaming, and the rocket's red glare, the bombs bursting in air, gave proof through the night that our flag was still there. Oh, say does that star-spangled banner yet wave o'er the land of the free and the home of the brave.
Ladies and gentlemen, Mr. Kyle Spiegel. Good evening, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome to the DeVos Fieldhouse here on the campus of Hope College for today's MIAA contest between the Bells of St. Mary's and your Hope College Flying Dutch. Here are tonight's starting lineups. First for St. Mary's at one forward, a 5'8 sophomore from Mokena, Illinois, number 15, Nicole Connolly. And at one forward for the Flying Dutch, a 5'11 sophomore from Crystal Lake, Illinois, number 5, Carson Carlbloom. At one forward for St. Mary's, a 5'9 senior from Manassas, Virginia, number 25, Mary Kate Garol. And at one forward for the Flying Dutch, a 5'10 sophomore from Byron Center, number 25, Sydney Viss.
Coming home again.
Starting at center for St. Mary's, a 6'2 senior from Troy, number 42, Athena Sampson. And at center for the Flying Dutch, a 6'2 senior from Grand Rapids, number 10, Raven Jemison. At one guard for St. Mary's, a 5'7 freshman from Wildwood, Missouri, number 2, Kate Rustovich. And at one guard for the Flying Dutch, a 5'6 junior from Midland, number 11, Jada Garner. And at the final guard spot for St. Mary's, a 5'7 freshman from Wildwood, Missouri, number 14, Annie Restovich. And at the final guard spot for the Flying Dutch, a 5'8 sophomore from New Albany, Indiana, number 12, Keegan Kaiser. St. Mary's is coached by Melissa McKelski. Hope College is coached by Brian Morehouse. Your officials this evening, Amanda Chapman, Ruben Rosalind, and Tim Fedeke.
If you don't know by now, I'm talking about...
Calvin University, just this past Saturday, they were able to edge them over in Grand Rapids, and St. Mary's looking to bounce back from a loss to Trine University last week. So we will see what will happen tonight. Two good teams going head-to-head. These two teams faced off back in December. Hope able to get the better of the Bells, 78-44. So St. Mary's looking to bounce back after that loss as well earlier in this season. We'll have Jemison and Sampson on the tip-off. Tip controlled by Hope. Jada Garner to start with it. Viss to Kaiser in the corner. She's going to drive baseline. Kicks it out to Carlbloom. She's going to try the three just off the back of the rim. No good. Rebounded by the Bells. Restovich to get things going for St. Mary's. She's going to get it inside to Sampson. Sampson looking out to Restovich. That one a little too strong from three. Great work on the boards by St. Mary's to get an offensive rebound. Kick out. That shot no good. Rebounded by Jemison. Gardner now with pace, headed the other way for the Dutch. Kaiser trying to work inside. Looking for a teammate. Carlbloom's going to try the three again. Deep three. This one no good. Rebounded by Sydney Viss. Great little pass off to Gardner. She gets stopped, though. Is going to kick it out. Jemison looking from the corner. She's going to drive in. Little reverse layup. Gets it to go off the glass. Great take by Raven Jemison to get things going. Hope with the early lead, 2-0. Kate Restovich now to get things going for the Bells. Sampson, guarded closely by Jemison. She's going to work inside. Great block by Raven Jemison. Hope headed the other way. This now, uncontested, going to drive in. Easy layup off the glass for Sydney Viss. St. Mary's just got caught in transition trying to find their player, and Sydney Viss right to the hole. Restovich now gets it over to Garreau in the corner. She's going to drive inside. A lot of contact. Ref says offensive foul, though. That's going to be Mary Kate Garreau's first foul. Sydney Viss able to step in there and draw the charge for the Flying Dutch. Jada Gardner now getting the call from head coach Brian Morehouse as she crosses the timeline. She's going to head right to the hoop, puts it off the glass a little too strong. Tipped out by Jemison's St. Mary's ball. 4-0, 8 minutes left here in this first quarter. Restovich trying to set up the offense. She gets it over to her sister. Out on that left wing, back inside to Restovich. She's going to try to put up a shot. That one unable to fall, rebounded by Hope. Hope now running fast in transition. Kaiser three from the corner. That one no good, rebounded by Hope. Kaiser now trying to work inside. Kick out to Carl Bloom, unable to connect with her, and this one is going to be an over and back call. First turnover of the night for the Flying Dutch. Annie Restovich inbounds to her sister Kate Restovich as she sets up the offense. Garreau over on that left wing, guarded closely by Carl Bloom, trying to make things difficult. Inside, Sampson. She kicks it out to Restovich. She's going to try the three, knocks it down. Big three by Annie Restovich to get things going for the Bells. Carl Bloom now working inside. Trying to find something. Gets the shot off the glass, able to fall. Carson Carl Bloom, 6-3. Hope extends their lead. Restovich now working on that right side, guarded closely by Garner. Gets it to Sampson. She's going to kick it out to Garreau. That shot is blocked by Jemison, but refs say Jemison just got a little too much of the hand there. They're going to call her for her first foul of the night as Mary Kate Garreau is going to head to the line. Excuse me, Nicole Connolly. My mistake. That'll be Nicole Connolly that's headed to the line. We get some new subs onto the floor. Number three, Lauren Guma for the Bells. Number 23, Olivia Bellos for Hope. 2, Chloe Brunsberg. 4, Lauren Leach. 22, Taryn Maynard. And 44, Courtney Lee. A full lineup change for the Flying Dutch as Connolly knocks down that first free throw. No good on the second. Connolly, a 64% free throw shooter on the year. Maynard now to set up the offense. Over to Leach. Leach to Brunsberg in the corner. Back out to Leach. Over to Maynard. Bellos now working in the corner. Too quick a feat for Olivia Bellos. Refs call her for a travel as St. Mary's will get the ball back. Restovich now crossing half court. Working on that left wing, trying to find options. Guma up top, she's gonna drive inside. Able to knock down the two. Sampson gets her first shot of the game to fall. Maynard now working at the other end. Brunsberg pump fakes in the corner. She's gonna try to drive inside. Out to Leach. Guarded closely by Guma. Leach is going to work off the Courtney Lee screen. That pass tipped away by Sampson. Great defense to jump in front of that pass. But it's going to stay with Hope College. 10 on the shot clock. Leach to inbound. Trying to find a teammate. She gets it into Bellows, almost intercepted by Restovich. Bellows pulls up from the elbow. That one rattles around the rim and falls off. Guma now setting up the offense for the Bells. Working over on that right side. Connolly now in the corner. Inside to Sampson. Sampson's going to try to get the shot up. That one no good. Rebounded by Courtney Lee. Maynard now with some pace. Headed back the other way. To Brunsberg in the corner. She pump fakes. Drives inside. Out to Bellows. Bellows. Nice little move inside, but that one too strong. Off the glass. No good. Refs say last touch by Hope, so that's going to be headed back to St. Mary's. Six-six, 5 minutes left in this first quarter. Restovich over on that left wing. Tries to get it to Conley. That pass is going to be tipped away by Brunsberg, though. It will stay with St. Mary's.
Entering the line for St. Mary's, number 32, Caroline Becker.
We apologize for some technical difficulties right now. Our scoreboard, trying to get it up on the live stream for you. I will do my best to keep you updated with the score along the way till we get that up and in place for you. Restovich tries the three. That one no good. Rebounded by Hope College as they head back the other way. Out to Bellows in the corner. She's going to drive inside. Nice little layup off the glass. Olivia Bellows. Hope leads 8-6. Restovich stopped up top. Trying to get it inside. She's going to drive in. No good off the rim. Rebounded by Brunsberg. Maynard now trying to get inside. Kick out to Leach. Leach swings it around to Brunsberg. Brunsberg driving inside is going to pick up the foul, though. They're going to get number 32, Caroline Recker, with her first foul of the night. St. Mary's second team foul of the quarter. We have a new sub for St. Mary's as well. Number 5, Naya Porter, checking in for the first time tonight. Bellows looking for options on that right wing. Out to Brunsberg. Leach now working up top. She's going to find Bellows in the corner. Bellows is going to try the three. That one a little short off the front of the rim, but she gets her own rebound. Great hustle by Olivia Bellows. Pass inside to Brunsberg, but they're going to say Brunsberg traveled, trying to get a better angle at the hoop. Turnover Hope. Restovich now setting up the offense. Guma guarded by Leach. Up top to Recker. Recker stops. That one's stripped away by Hope, though. Maynard speeding the other way. Up off the glass. 2 points for Taryn Maynard. Hope leads 10-6. Just over 3 minutes left in this first quarter. Courtney Lee, great job jumping that pass. Steal it away as Maynard heads back the other way again. Maynard trying to find a teammate. Leach thinks about the three. Puts it on the floor, though. Maynard guarded closely by St. Mary's, making everything difficult for her. Brunsberg is going to drive inside. Tried to pass to Lee, but I don't know if Courtney Lee thought that was going to her. Just a little miscommunication. But Maynard there is able to clean it up and put the ball in the hoop for Hope College. 12-6. Hope leads. Guma over to Restovich. She's going to try the deep three. That one no good. Rebounded by Courtney Lee. Bellows over on that right side, trying to get into the lane. That one no good. Rebounded for a second by Courtney Lee, but just tipped into the wrong hands as Guma heads back the other way for St. Mary's. Restovich drives inside, is going to draw the foul. Foul on Olivia Bellows. That's going to be her first of the night as we see the starters back in for Hope College, something that head coach Brian Morehouse is known for, going with that five-in, five-out strategy, trying to keep fresh legs on the floor. As deep as Hope College is in their bench, it's something that they're able to do night in and night out. D deep three from Annie Restovich. She's able to knock it down to give this offense a little spark. Cuts into the Hope College lead. Hope only up by three, 12-9, 2 minutes to go in this first quarter. Kaiser up top to Jemison. Jemison handoff to Carl Bloom. Surveys the floor. She's going to get it over to Kaiser. Kaiser drives in, kick out to Sydney Viss. Viss is going to try the three, knocks it down. Sydney Viss for three. Huge three from Sydney Viss there in the corner. Sampson now, guarded by Jemison. Guma gets her way inside, tries to put up a shot, but she's going to be fouled, so she's going to have a pair of free throws coming up. They're going to get Jada Gardner for her first foul of the night. That's going to be Hope's third team foul of this quarter. Guma knocks down the first. She's a 57% free throw shooter on the year. The 5'2 junior out of Troy, Michigan, comes into this game averaging a little over 3 points a game. Able to knock down both at that trip to the line as Garner heads back the other way for the Flying Dutch. Viss working over on that right wing. Jemison now tries to get it to Garner, but that's going to be tipped away by Guma as she jumped that pass. Just going to stay with Hope. 18 seconds left on the shot clock. Carl Bloom into Garner. She's going to set up the offense. Viss now drives inside, puts the shot up. That one a little short off the front of the rim, rebounded by St. Mary's. Connolly now headed the other way. Out to Restovich. Back to Connolly in the corner. Guarded by Sydney Viss. She's going to feed inside Sampson. Sampson up off the glass, too strong, rebounded by Garner. Garner, a little spin move as she's guarded closely by Guma. Viss to Carbloom in the corner. Skip pass to Kaiser. Skip again back to Garner in the corner. Great ball movement by the Flying Dutch. Great pass inside by Raven Jemison to get it to Sydney Viss, but she is just swallowed up by that St. Mary's defense, and they're going to force the jump ball. And that possession arrow is going to favor St. Mary's. As we're going to see some new faces for the Flying Dutch, number 21, Brooklyn Roback, and number 3, Hannah Currents, checking in for the first time tonight. Guma now crossing half court. A little less than a second differential between the shot clock and game clock, so St. Mary's could hold for the last shot of this quarter here. Guma working off the Sampson pick. And they're going to get her for a travel. So Hope going to have about 9 seconds left in this quarter. We'll see what play head coach Brian Morehouse draws up for this team. Garner now working with some pace. Over to Viss. Handoff back to Garner. Little floater in the lane off the glass. Great looking shot from Jada Garner to end the quarter as Hope takes a lead into the second quarter, 17-11. We're going to step away for just a minute. We'll be back on the other side of this break.
Whether you're building your dream home, buying a fixer-upper, or downsizing, the process can feel overwhelming. Let the local team at Lighthouse Title help the closing process be one less worry. Just ask your real estate professional or lender to close at Lighthouse Title. To learn more about how we're involved in our 35 communities or to ask us any questions about the process, visit us online at lighthousetitle.net.
Gentex is a tech company supplying electro-optical products to the global automotive, aerospace, and fire protection industries. With focused competencies in design, vision, displays, software, and more, we're always looking for engineering talent. For our direct hire hourly production positions, we run open interviews Monday through Friday from 8 to 5 at our 58 East Riley facility in Zeeland. And our facilities, benefits, and culture are everything you'd expect from a world-class employer. Now's the time to join Team Gentex.
Welcome back. As we get this second quarter started, Hope leads 17-11 as we begin play. Hope with the ball. Olivia Bellos working over on that right wing. She's going to try to drive inside. Kick out to Brunsberg. Brunsberg is going to try the three. That one just a little too strong off the back of the rim. Looks like refs are going to get a foul call here. We're going to get number 25, Mary-Kate Groh, on the foul as Chloe Brunsberg was trying to track down the rebound to her own shot. So Hope is going to get the ball out of bounds underneath. That's going to be Groh's second of the night, first of the quarter. Bellos now, she's going to try the contested three, knocks it down with a hand in her face. Olivia Bellos, big three to get this offense started in the second quarter. Restovich now, guarded by Maynard. Gets it to Sampson. Sampson trying to get to the hoop. That one off the side of the backboard, rebounded by Hope. Leach trying to find Lee inside. They're going to get another foul on St. Mary's. I believe they're going to get, yep, number three, Lauren Guma, as she was trying to just contest that pass a little bit into Courtney Lee.
That is her first, team second.
And we're going to get some subs for the Bells. Number 24, Avery Schieser, and number 12, Alyssa Matuza. We've got another foul on St. Mary's. This one is going to be on number 12, Alyssa Matuza, right after she checks in. So a quick three fouls about 45 seconds into this quarter for St. Mary's. Maynard looking to inbound, gets it to Leach. A little jumper in the lane, able to knock it down. Lauren Leach, 2 points. 22-11, Hope extending their lead. 9 minutes left in the second quarter. Restovich over to Conley. Conley now going to try to get inside, pulls it back out. Guarded closely by Brunsberg. Tries to get it over to Sampson, but that one goes through Sampson's legs, picked up by Hope. Bellos now streaking the other way. Inside, contested, hard layup. She's going to get fouled and head to the free throw line. And I believe they're going to get number 15, Nicole Connolly, for that foul. As we take a look at that replay, you see her just kind of swipe in at the arm of Olivia Bellos as she's trying to go in for that layup. So two shots for Olivia Bellos. She's able to knock down the first one. Second one coming for Olivia Bellos. That one rattles around the rim, and falls out, rebounded by St. Mary's. Restovich now trying to get something going for her offense. Over to Connolly. She's going to be doubled over on that right side. And refs are going to say that she traveled as she fell to the floor. It's going to head back, Flying Dutch way. Maynard now setting up the offense, calling out the play for her team. Gets it to Lee. Lee looking for options. Out to Leach. Leach now uses the Lee pick. Courtney Lee trying to spin inside. That one too strong off the glass, rebounded by Sampson. Restovich now over to Conley. Conley surveys the floor. She's going to work her way inside. Kick out into the corner. Triple try by number 12, Alyssa Matuza, knocks down the three. And Coach Morehouse calls a quick substitution timeout, wanting to get number 12, Keegan Kaiser, into the game as Brunsberg is going to take a rest. 23-13, Hope College still leads in the second quarter. Maynard to get things going on this possession. over to Leach. Leach is going to try the three. Knocks it down. Lauren Leach, 26-13. Hope College leads. And we're going to get a timeout by St. Mary's as head coach Melissa Mikelski wants to talk things over with her team. 30-second timeout. We're going to step away for just a second, and we'll see you back here in a few moments.
Custer Insurance Agency is a proud sponsor of Hope Athletics.
Welcome back to DeVos Fieldhouse. Hope leads 26-13 in the second quarter, and I had the opportunity to talk with head coach Brian Morehouse right before this game, and I want to give a special shout out to his mom, Jean Morehouse. Just had shoulder surgery this past Monday, so she is tuning in from Fremont, Michigan, as well as Coach Morehouse's dad, Dean Morehouse, also known as Biggie, to this Hope women's basketball team. Want to give a special shout out to you guys. We're glad you're tuning in, but we are excited to have you back in DeVos Fieldhouse soon. And Jean, we wish you a great recovery over these next few weeks. Hope able to force the turnover on that last possession, so they're going to get the ball headed the other way as Maynard crosses the timeline for the Flying Dutch. Lee at the top of the key, over to Leach. Leach, a little too quick feet for her. She's going to get the travel called. St. Mary's able to stop Hope once again. Restovich inbounds to her sister. She crosses half court to set up the offense. Skip pass over to Conley. Conley's going to drive inside, looking for a teammate now. Gets it to Restovich. That ball's tipped around. Able to get inside. A little floater over the shoulder for Kate Restovich. Guarded closely inside the lane there. Kaiser now trying to work inside. She gets stopped. Dumps it off to Courtney Lee. Lee back out to Kaiser. Kaiser swings it around. Bellows is going to try the three. That one is off right. Offensive rebound by Maynard. Maynard puts it up. That one rolls around the rim for a second and falls good for Hope College. 28-15. Hope College leads 6-12 left in the second quarter. Restovich stopped up top. Gets it over to Conley. Conley now guarded by Kaiser. She's going to try to bounce it all the way across the court to Schieser, but that one is going to head out of bounds as Hope College forces another turnover. A lot of new faces checking in for both teams on that possession. Let's take a look. We've got number 5, Nia Porter, checking back into the game. 32, Caroline Recker for the Bells. Garner sets up the offense, trying to direct traffic over to Viss. Jemison now looking for options. Garner's going to get inside. Kick out to Carl Bloom. She's going to try the three. That one a little too strong. Offensive rebound by Sydney Viss. That one sat on the rim for a second, falled off. Another offensive rebound. Viss going to try a three. That one no good as well. Several opportunities, but none able to find the bottom of the basket for Hope. Restovich now guarded by Carl Bloom. Trying to find her way inside, out to Conley. Conley tries a step back three. That one didn't hit anything. Jemison trying to get the rebound, but they're going to call number 5, Nia Porter, for a foul. Just came over top of Jemison a little too strong. Hit her in the back on that one. And that is going to be St. Mary's 5th team foul of the quarter with 5:13 left in this quarter. So Jemison is going to head to the line for 2 free throws. Jemison, the only senior on this roster, 6'2 center out of Grand Rapids, Michigan. Able to knock down the first free throw. Jemison, the second on the way. unable to get the second one. That one bounces off the rim, rebounded by St. Mary's. As Guma heads back the other way to set up the offense. Over to Recker. Recker now to Restovich in the corner. Skip pass to Restovich. That three try a little too strong off of Jemison as she was trying to pull down the rebound. It's going to stay with St. Mary's, but the shot did not hit anything at the rim, so only 16 seconds remain on the shot clock for St. Mary's. Guma looking to inbound, gets it into Porter. Porter able to get that little layup to fall. 29-17, Hope still leads. Hope with some pace, headed back the other way. This out to Carlbloom. Carlbloom off the glass, gets it to go as she falls to the ground after that one. Carlbloom with some contact, able to get that layup to fall. Guma now guarded closely by Kaiser. Restovich is going to knock down the deep contested triple as St. Mary's is trying to hang around as this second quarter ticks down. 31-20, Hope still leads, but St. Mary's not going anywhere. Garner to Jemison. Jemison looking for some options. Back to Garner. She's going to try to get inside, out to Kaiser. Jemison skips over to Viss. Viss now to try to drive inside. She's going to find a lot of contact and is going to head to the free throw line as she draws the foul on that layup attempt. And they're going to get number three, Lauren Guma, on that foul. As we take a look at this replay, see Viss just a great job trying to initiate some contact, create a play there, and Guma's going to pick up her second foul.
For St. Mary's, number 12, Alyssa Matusa.
Sydney Viss shooting 77% from the free throw line so far this year. Knocks down the first one calmly. The 5'10 sophomore out of Byron Center, Michigan, has been a great shooter so far this year for the Hope College Flying Dutch team as she knocks down the second free throw. 33-20, Hope extends their lead by two. Restovich is going to try the three again. That one bounces around the rim and falls out as Garner comes away with the rebound, and she's going to be fouled again. So a lot of fouls here for the St. Mary's team in this second quarter as Garner's going to head to the free throw line now for a pair of her own.
St. Mary's number 42, Athena Simpson.
As we mentioned a few minutes ago, St. Mary's picked up three very quick in that first minute of this second quarter. So we're going to see, I'm guessing, a lot of free throws the rest of this quarter for Hope College. Garner unable to connect on the first one. That one just a little too strong off the back of the rim. A 74% free throw shooter on the year. Second one on the way. Nothing but net for Jada Garner. 34-20, Hope leads. Restovich now surveys the floor. Working on that left side. Up top to Recker, but they're going to call the travel on Recker as she was trying to drive inside. Feet moving a little too fast. Carlbloom to inbound to Gardner as she calls out the play for this Flying Dutch women's basketball team. Up top to Viss. Viss over to Carlbloom. Crosses over, trying to get inside. Great skip pass over to Brunsberg. Brunsberg just a little too strong. Carlbloom there to work for that rebound. Gets it to Viss. Viss out to Gardner. Corner triple try. That one too strong for Jada Gardner. Viss working for another offensive rebound, and I believe they're going to get another foul on St. Mary's. That one's going to be on number 42, Athena Sampson. It's going to be her first as Sydney Viss goes back to the line for two more free throws. That one's short for Sydney Viss. So a lot of fouls here we're seeing from St. Mary's in this second quarter, and a lot of trips to the free throw line for Hope College as a result. Viss able to knock down the second, nothing but net. She's now got 8 points tonight. Restovich headed the other way. That one off the side of the backboard, rebounded by Courtney Lee. Lee gets it to Gardner. She's going to push the pace now. Out to Carl Bloom. Back to Gardner. Back over to Carl Bloom. She's going to try to work inside. Brunsberg now with it. Over to Gardner. This in the corner. And she's going to draw another foul. So we're going to see two more free throws for Sydney Viss in just a moment. That foul is going to be on number two, Kate Restovich. That's going to be her first of the game. We see just a little too much contact there as Sydney Viss trying to drive baseline. Viss able to knock down that one. Nothing but net. 9 points for her now tonight as she leads this Hope College team. Viss perfect on that trip to the free throw line. 37-20. Hope leads by 17. 2.5 left in the second quarter. As several subs head to the table for Hope College. Restovich trying to find a teammate. Sampson now driving inside, and she's going to draw a foul. So that's going to be the first foul on Hope College of this quarter. They're going to get number 25, Sydney Viss, on that one. So we take a look at this replay. Viss just kind of reaches in there, trying to tip the ball away, but just gets too much of Sampson's arm. And they're going to say that was on the shot as well. So Sampson will have two shots of her own. Athena Sampson, first opportunity, rattles around the rim and falls out. The 6'2 senior out of Troy, Michigan, shooting 52% from the free throw line this year. Second one on the way, that one too strong off the back of the rim, rebounded by Maynard. Maynard now over to Brunsberg. Leach looking for a teammate, back over to Brunsberg. She's going to drive baseline. Hammer pass over to Maynard. Maynard three from the corner. That one too strong. Offensive rebound, Hope. Brunsberg is going to pull it out. Reset the offense. Leach now over to Bellows. Bellows trying to get inside. Kicks it back out. Brunsberg over to Lee. Lee swallowed up again by the St. Mary's defense, and they're going to say held ball, possession arrow favoring the Bells. So great defensive possession there by St. Mary's, trying to make things difficult every time Hope worked inside. Restovich now trying to see if her team can get a bucket at this end of the floor. Great pass over to number 24, Avery Schieser. That one too strong off the glass, rebounded by Hope. Maynard to Bellows. Bellows out to Leach. Into the corner to Brunsberg, back to Leach. Bellows now working on this left wing. She's gonna drive inside, great pass to Courtney Lee. That one just unable to drop for Courtney Lee, but Olivia Bellows able to sneak that one through such a small window. And as Courtney Lee was, or excuse me, as Olivia Bellows is trying to go for a rebound there, she's gonna pick up her second foul of the game. Second team foul for Hope in this second quarter. 1:09 left to play. Restovich guarded by Maynard. Kicks it out to Matuza. Matuza swallowed up by this Hope defense. And refs say it's going to be a Hope College foul. I believe they're going to get, number two, Chloe Brunsberg, for the foul on that one. So now we're seeing a couple consecutive Hope College fouls. It felt like in the first half of this quarter, it was all St. Mary's fouls. Now Hope starting to pick some up. That shot a little too strong for Athena Sampson, rebounded by Hope. Inside to Jemison. Jemison back out to Bello. She pump fakes, drives inside. Great pass out to Lauren Leach. Leach unable to knock down the three, but rebounded by Jemison. Jemison over to Bellows. She's going to put up the little runner, but she's going to be fouled. Two free throws coming up next for Olivia Bellows.
St. Mary's fouls number 12, Alyssa Matuza.
And they got number 12, Alyssa Matuza, for the foul for St. Mary's on that last play. Bellows calmly knocks down the first free throw. Second one on the way. Knocks down the second. Olivia Bellows perfect on that trip to the free throw line. She now has 8 points tonight for the Flying Dutch. .36 seconds left in this half. We've got about a 7 second differential between shot clock and game clock. St. Mary's guarded closely by Hope near that half court line. Conley now working inside, out to Restovich. She's gonna try the three, knocks it down, nothing but net. Kate Restovich. Hope now going with some pace, seeing if they can get a shot before the end of this half. Over to Maynard. Maynard drives in, little floater in the lane, gets it to go. Taryn Maynard, great looking runner from her. 3 seconds now. And they're gonna get an over and back call for St. Mary's, so Hope is gonna have 1 second left on the clock to see if maybe they can throw up a quick last shot to end this quarter. St. Mary's just caught going a little too quick. Gets the over and back call. Leach now to Jemison. Jemison tries to pass it over to Bellows, but not quite enough time to make that pass and get a shot off. Either way, the shot didn't fall, wouldn't have counted. So Hope leads 41-23 heading into halftime. We'll be back in about 15 minutes for the second half from DeVos Fieldhouse.
Whether you're building your dream home, buying a fixer-upper, or downsizing, the process can feel overwhelming. Let the local team at Lighthouse Title help the closing process be one less worry. Just ask your real estate professional or lender to close at Lighthouse Title. To learn more about how we're involved in our 35 communities or to ask us any questions about the process, visit us online at lighthousetitle.net.
In our popular mythology, revolutions happen in Silicon Valley, right? But no, the revolution happened here.
I think we are starting a revolution, but it's coming from a very strong sense of who we are.
Immediately creating a multi-generational community.
There's something magical happens when you shift from being a payer to being a giver.
Hope Forward has 58 students, I think, today-ish. You know, when we started in 94, we had 47. It's doable. What they're trying to do is doable. Getting people to believe early on is the hardest part.
It has given people a sense of belonging to a cause greater than themselves.
This can happen, this is possible, and we need each of you to be brand ambassadors for this initiative.
We're all aware of the crisis in American education. There are other crises as well that I think are linked to it. The second is the crisis facing our young people, the mental health crisis. And the third crisis is the crisis in our church. And when I look at what is happening here at this school, in this community, I see it as not just addressing the first of those crises, but all three of them.
The students are incredible, and the idea is incredible. Why not 30 years from now, this is the norm?
I've said this a million times, but who better than a place called Hope to run toward things that to the world look hopeless?
Gentex is a tech company supplying electro-optical products to the global automotive, aerospace, and fire protection industries. With focused competencies in design, vision, displays, software, and more, we're always looking for engineering talent. For our direct hire hourly production positions, we run open interviews Monday through Friday from 8 to 5 at our 58 East Riley facility in Zeeland. And our facilities, benefits, and culture are everything you'd expect from a world-class employer. Now's the time to join Team Gentex.
Yeah.
My name is Travis Williams. I'm the CEO of the ODC Network. I graduated from Hope in 1998. I studied biology, and then I also played football. In order to be successful, people really need more than just the academic experience, but they need people to come alongside them and help them, coach them, mentor them. I find that Hope College has just been one of the best examples of being able to do that anywhere.
As an invested community partner, LVZ is proud to help share Hope stories of transformational impact.
Insurance Agency is a proud sponsor of Hope Athletics.
A smile, the universal hello. A friendly welcome and a sign of confidence. A simple smile can brighten someone's day. At Mayu Dentistry, we design beautiful smiles for the whole family. We strive to meet your individual goals with the latest technology to give you a healthy, lasting smile. Mayu Dentistry, where smiles begin. Proud partners of Hope Athletics.
There are over 5,000 colleges and universities in the United States alone, and nearly every single one of them is named after a location or a historical figure. But along the shores of Lake Michigan, there is a school whose namesake is not a founder, not a historical figure, not a state, city, or physical landmark. It is named after an ideal, a virtue, a way of life. Its name is Hope. It is so easy to get lost in what this world lacks, to become discouraged by its needs, gaps, and flaws. Can we see beyond the uncertainty and brokenness? At Hope College, we do. Not by ignoring the world as it is, but by learning and living with the belief that this is not the world as it should be, by driving to understand, to unlock clarity, to amplify truth, by leading with inspired compassion, by embodying a vision that illuminates greater opportunity for all, by serving with anchored conviction, using our collective gifts to offer this world what it needs most, hope. Not simply hope as a desire, but hope as a way of being. Because hope has changed the way we see the world, and hope drives us to change the way the world is. Because hope shapes our calling. Because hope inspires our dreams. Because hope empowers our talents. Because hope frees us to try. Because hope transforms what we believe, transforms how we act, transforms who we are. At Hope College, we know this life-altering grace is a gift we have all been given, and it is the greatest gift we can offer the world. Hope transforms.
nothing can top me. I feel like I'm space. It's bigger than profit, but still I get paid. My thinking colossal, not minimum wage. Talk to the lost like I know the way. Stay on my job like who need a break? It was impossible, I heard them say. But I'm like MacGyver to all my mistakes. Run it back home, now look at the bases. Been winning so long, I feel like a native. I got what you want, but you cannot take it. I do what you don't, cause I'm a creator.
To DeVos Fieldhouse here as we are a few minutes away from starting the second half between this matchup between Hope College and St. Mary's. Hope leads 41-23 as we look to start this second half. Taking a look at some stats from the first half, Sydney Viss leads the way of all scores in the game with 10 points, followed closely on her team by Taryn Maynard and Olivia Bellos, each with 8. On the other end of the floor, Annie Restovich leads the St. Mary's Bells with 9 on the game. St. Mary's shooting 50% from the free throw line, 40% from the three-point line, compared to Hope College shooting only 23% from the three-point line. So they have struggled so far in this game, but they will look to see if they can pick that up in the second half and continue to extend this lead. Giving you a little update from Angola, Indiana, the Hope College Flying Dutch men's team headed down to Trine University tonight, and they currently lead 19-12 with just over 10 minutes left in the first half. So I will keep you guys updated on that score as well as we go throughout this second half. A great matchup on the men's side in MIAA action tonight. I also want to take a second tonight to give a shout out to some friends that I found out are tuning in all the way tonight from Waco, Texas. So this broadcast reaching across the country, one in particular, Cassie Godfrey, is tuning in, listening to us, celebrating her 25th birthday. So happy birthday to you, Cassie, and thank you for listening to this broadcast as we are just a few moments away from the second half between Hope College Flying Dutch and the St. Mary's Bells. Both teams are going to head back out with their original starters to get this second half going. Hope will start with possession. Carlbloom to inbound to Gardner. Over to Jemison. Jemison looking back over to Gardner. Gardner's going to feed this inside. She works in the post, up off the glass, too strong, rebounded by Athena Sampson. St. Mary sprinting the other way. Restovich over on that right wing. Guarded closely by Gardner. Restovich drives inside. Out to Garreau. She's stopped by Carlbloom. Back out to Restovich. Inside to Sampson. Sampson swallowed up by that Hope College defense, but she's able to get it away. Kick out to Restovich. Restovich tries the three, buries it. Kate Restovich for three to get things going for the St. Mary's Bells in the second half. Hope now trying to answer. This in the corner. Out to Jemison. Jemison drives inside, too strong off the glass, gets her own rebound. Up, that one swallowed up by Athena Sampson. Able to just get her hand on top of the ball and strip that one away as Jemison was trying to get the shot off. Restovich now straight to the hoop. Kate Restovich, 5 points from her to start this second half. 41-28, Hope leads by 13. Kaiser over on that right side. Tries to find Jemison, but that pass tipped away into the hands of Sydney Viss. Viss, that ball skips around, back to Kaiser. Kaiser again trying to get a pass off. That one tipped away again. This time St. Mary's comes away with it. Garreau stopped up top. Over to Annie Restovich. Over to Conley. Conley gets inside. That shot just a little too strong off the glass. Almost an and-one opportunity for Nicole Conley. But she is going to head to the line for two free throws as Carson Carlbloom picks up her first foul. First foul for either team in the second half. Connolly unable to knock down the first one from this trip to the line. She's shooting 64% from the line this year. Gets the second one to go. 41-29, St. Mary's slowly trying to chip into this Hope College lead. Carlbloom now headed right to the bucket. Great pass over to Jemison. Jemison's going to get it right back outside. Ball skipping around up top. Viss drives inside. That one unable to fall. Gets her own rebound, though. Carlbloom now. Triple try. Got it. Carson Carlbloom for three to get things going for Hope College in the second half. Their first points the quarter. Restovich. Kick out to Conley. Excuse me. Not Conley. That was Garreau in the corner. And she's going to draw the foul on Carson Carlbloom. So that's two quick ones for her in this quarter. Two team fouls for Hope now. Restovich looking to inbound. Tries to find her sister. That one tipped away by Gardner. Great defense from her to knock that pass down. It's going to stay at this end of the floor. 21 seconds on the shot clock. Annie Restovich. Waiting for the play to develop. Gets it out to Garreau. Over to Restovich. She's going to work inside, guarded by Gardner. Kick out. Connolly deep to. That one just short. Sydney Viss tracks down the rebound. Hope headed the other way. Viss right to the hole. That one unable to fall. Rebounded by St. Mary's. Just a little out of control for Sydney Viss and then transition. Restovich gets stopped in the lane. Kick out to Garreau. She's going to try the two. That one too strong. Didn't connect with anything as Garner didn't even hear or see that shot. Kind of hit her in the foot and bounced around. We're going to get a held ball underneath. It's going to stay at this end of the floor with St. Mary's. Courtney Lee now is going to check in for the Flying Dutch. as Raven Jemison will take a rest. Restovich, deep triple try. That one just a little too short. Garner sails up to get the rebound. Over to Viss. Viss, kick out to Kaiser. Kaiser's going to try the corner three. That one unable to fall. Carlbloom gets the rebound, puts it back up, and good. Carson Carlbloom with her 9 points of the game. Restovich now setting up the offense, gets it inside to Conley. Conley off the glass and in. Great pass there by Kate Restovich to find her teammate, cutting to the basket. Carlbloom over to Garner. Carlbloom tries to feed it inside to Kaiser. That one's going to go off Kaiser's hands as it tips around a couple different players, and St. Mary's is going to come away with it. Few subs into this ball game. Avery Schieser for St. Mary's, as well as Taryn Maynard, Lauren Leach, and Olivia Bellows checking in, and Chloe Brunsberg as well. Sampson now guarded by Lee. She's going to try to make her way to the basket. Kick out to Connolly. Connolly, little hook shot. That one rattles around the rim and falls off the rim. Lauren Leach, as she was going up for the rebound, fouled by Sampson. That's going to be their second team foul of the quarter.
Team's first.
Maynard now setting up the offense. Over to Brunsberg. Brunsberg over to Bellows. She's going to work her way inside. Weaving through defenders, Bellows gets the shot off and draws the foul. So she's going to have two more free throws coming up. So we take a look at this replay. Olivia Bellows just weaving her way through there. Really shifty moves to try to get to the rim and finds the contact, and it's going to result in two free throws. Bellows knocks down the first, her 9th point of the night. One more on the way. Calmly knocks it down. 10 points now on the night for Olivia Bellows. Hope now coming out in a little full court pressure, picking up St. Mary's. Just trying to make things difficult. Connolly breaks the press over to Guma. Guma, great pass to Porter. That one, not enough on it as Courtney Lee comes away with it. Maynard now headed the other way. She kicks out to Leach. Leach is going to try the three. That one too short. Rebounded by St. Mary's. And Maynard with some full court pressure trying to make things tough on St. Mary's. Connolly now with it, over to Guma. Guarded by Maynard. Tries to get it over to Restovich. That one's gonna be tipped away by Olivia Bellows, though it's gonna stay with St. Mary's. 13 seconds left on the shot clock. Schieser to inbound. Connolly now working on the left side. Over to Porter. She's going to try the elbow jumper. That one too strong. Rebounded by Hope. Maynard working inside. Out to Brunsberg. Triple try. That one rolls off the rim. Rebounded by Bellows. She's going to go up strong again, and it's going to draw a foul yet again. Olivia Bellows. Another trip to the free throw line for her. Olivia Bellows able just to find her way to the right spot on the floor to put herself in a position to get that rebound, and it results in drawing a foul and an opportunity at two more points for this team. First one on the way. That one just a little too strong, bounces off the back of the rim. Bellows now, second opportunity. She knocks that one down. 49-31, Hope College leads. 5:01 left to play in this third quarter. Kate Restovich setting up the offense for the Bells. gets it over to Schieser. Back to Restovich. Up top, triple try. That one no good. Rebounded by St. Mary's. Trying to get out of the corner. Guarded closely by Hope. A lot of contact on that baseline. Restovich trying to pass it to a teammate, but that's going to be tipped out by Lauren Leach. 13 seconds left on the shot clock as St. Mary's will have it under the hoop inbounding. Restovich looking for a teammate. Gets it into Recker. Restovich setting up the offense, 8 on the shot clock. Jemison comes out to hedge, makes things a little difficult. Step back for Restovich. She is swallowed up by Maynard. Unable to get that shot to fall. Rebounded by Leach, and they're going to say Caroline Recker fouled Lauren Leach as she was trying to rip that one away. Looked like Recker just kind of tied up the ball. I thought we were going to get a jump ball for a second, but ref said she got a little too much of the arm. So fourth team foul for St. Mary's in this third quarter. Maynard now trying to get something going. Out to Bellows. Over to Leach on the right side. She's going to work inside. A lot of contact. Unable to get the layup to fall, but Lauren Leach is going to have two free throws coming up. Foul is going to be on number 24, Avery Schieser.
That is her first team's fifth.
And that's going to be St. Mary's fifth team foul of the quarter. So Hope will be shooting free throws here on out, regardless of the foul type. Leach unable to connect with the first attempt. Knocks down the second. Lauren Leach is 66% free throw shooter on the year. Restovich now guarded by Maynard. Maynard trying to tip that one away, making things difficult. Over to Recker in the corner. She knocks it down, nothing but net. Caroline Recker, for three. Bellows now working on the right wing. Over to Jemison. Jemison now going right at Porter, tries to get the shot off. Looked like one ref was going to call a foul. Another said a travel before, though. A little deliberation on the floor, but it looks like it's going to be a travel on Raven Jemison. So St. Mary's is going to force a turnover. Restovich over to Porter. Hand off to Recker. Recker's going to try the free throw line jumper. That one off the glass, rebounded by Bellows. Hope with some pace, headed the other way. Out to Brunsberg. She's going to try the three. That one a little short, rattles around there. And Bellows again with another offensive rebound. Maynard over to Leach. She's going to feed Jemison inside. Jemison, hard take, tries to put the little reverse layup off the glass. She's going to be fouled by Porter, so two free throws coming up for Raven Jemison.
That is her third. Catching the lineup for St. Mary's.
So we take a look there. Raven Jemison just able to make her way to the baseline, get under the hoop, but unable to find that spot on the glass to get the shot to fall. But with the contact, she's going to have an opportunity for two. Jemison shooting 63% from the free throw line this year. First one on the way. That one is good. Her fourth point of the night. Jemison now, second opportunity. Knocks it down. Two more points for Raven Jemison as we see some subs coming into the game. Number 3, Guma for St. Mary's, as well as Jada Gardner, Keegan Kaiser, and Hannah Kearns back into the ballgame for the Flying Dutch. Guma now to cross the timeline with it for the Bells. Gets it to Garreau, over to Schieser. She works her way inside. A lot of contact there, but just straight up defense from Hannah Kearns and Raven Jemison as they're able to get the ball. Kaiser over to Viss. Viss back out to Garner. Garner to Kearns. And they're going to say Kurt's travel just pulled that pivot foot a little too soon as she was trying to work her way into the lane. Turnover Hope. Lauren Guma back with it for the Bells. Great defense by Jada Garner. She forces a steal, heads the other way. Layup off the glass and in. 2 points, Jada Garner. Extends this Hope College lead to 20. 54-34, just under 2 minutes left in this third quarter. Garner, great defense on Guma. Garreau gonna try the deep two. But as Sydney Viss kind of worked her way back around her, she fouled her on the arm as that shot was going up. So two free throws coming up for Mary Kay Garreau. That'll be Viss's second foul of the night. Only number three as a team for Hope College. Garreau, first one, rattles around the rim and falls out. 70% free throw shooter so far this year, Mary Kate Garreau. Second one on the way. That one no good as well, rebounded by Sydney Viss. Jemison, top of the key. She's gonna drive inside. Guarded by Garreau, kick out to Garner. Garner, triple try, knocks it down. Jada Garner for three. Big three-pointer right in front of her bench for Jada Garner. Guma now at the other end, over to Conley. Conley guarded by Viss. She's gonna drive inside. That pass tipped away by Hannah Kearns. It's gonna stay with St. Mary's. Conley will inbound right in front of her own bench. Looking for a teammate. Gets it out to Guma. Guma over to Garreau. Garreau's gonna drive inside, kick out to Guma. She's gonna try the three. That one off the top of the backboard. Falls into the hands of Sydney Viss. Almost went out of bounds. Garner kind of fumbled the pass off her foot, but she's able to come away with it. Kaiser now inside, puts up a little floater, gets that shot to fall. 2 points for Keegan Kaiser, 59-34. Hope College leads. 45 seconds left in this quarter. Sydney Viss with the steal, headed the other way. Great take by Sydney Viss. 2 more points for her. She now has 12 on the night, leading all scorers. Guma guarded closely by Garner. Over to Garreau. Viss trying to come in and force a jump ball, but just gets a little too much on the arm there. She's gonna pick up a foul. Only fourth team foul, so no free throws yet for St. Mary's, but that is Sydney Viss's third of the game. 26 seconds left in this quarter, 20 on the shot clock for the Bells. Connolly looking to inbound. Gets it to Guma. Guarded by Garner. Guma goes right around her, off the glass. That one no good. Tipped around as Connolly gets the rebound, puts the shot back up, and she's going to draw the foul. That's going to be on Carson Carlbloom. That's going to be her third. So Carlbloom now with three fouls in this third quarter alone. As Conley will have two free throws coming up. We can see Conley working to get that rebound and just a little too much contact from Carlbloom there as Conley was going back up with the shot. An update from Angola, Indiana. Hope leads by two, 31-29 at the half. So Hope looking to steal one on the road tonight down in Indiana. Conley knocks down that free throw. 16 seconds left in this quarter. Garner calmly sets up the offense for the Flying Dutch. Kaiser now with it. Free throw line jumper knocks it down. Great looking shot from Keegan Kaiser as quarter comes to an end. 63-36. Hope extends their lead in that quarter. We're going to take a break for just a minute. We'll see you on the other side for the fourth quarter.
Hey, my name is Travis Williams. I'm the CEO of the ODC Network. I graduated from Hope in 1998. I studied biology, and then I also played football.
In order to be successful, people really need more than just the academic experience, but they need people to come alongside them and help them, coach them, mentor them. I find that Hope College has just been one of the best examples of being able to do that anywhere.
As an invested community partner, LVZ is proud to help share Hope stories of transformational impact.
A smile, the universal hello. A friendly welcome and a sign of confidence. A simple smile can brighten someone's day. At Mayu Dentistry, we design beautiful smiles for the whole family. We strive to meet your individual goals with the latest technology to give you a healthy, lasting smile. Mayu Dentistry, where smiles begin. Proud partners of Hope Athletics.
There is a school whose namesake is not a founder, not a historical figure, not a state, city, or physical landmark. It is named after an ideal, a virtue, a way of life. Its name is Hope.
To DeVos Fieldhouse as we get ready to start this fourth quarter. Hope College leads St. Mary's 63-36 as we see a lot of new faces for this Hope College team. Number 24, Lena Rea. Number 15, Grayson Guy. Number 20, Lauren Nemmons. I want to make sure I'm not missing anyone. And number 21, Brooklyn Roback into the game. Roback, great pass inside to Lily Miller. That one bounces around the rim and unable to fall. Rebounded by St. Mary's. Restovich now over on the left side. Skip pass over back to Connolly. Restovich thinks about the three. She's going to try the three and knocks it down. Annie Restovich, another triple for her on the night. Nemmons now working inside. Over to Roback. Roback's going to get inside. Tries to get the shot off, but that one's blocked by Annie Restovich as St. Mary's heads the other way. Over to Restovich. She saw spots up on that left wing. Knocks it down. Annie Restovich catching some fire in the second half. 15 points for her. Rea now setting up the offense. Pass over to Guy. That one's tipped away, though. But off of Grayson Guy's hands. Headed back to St. Mary's. Kate Restovich setting up the offense, seeing if they can get a little spark in this fourth quarter. Connolly inside to Sampson, kick out Restovich. She's gonna try the three again, why not? That one's short though, rebounded by Hope. Rea with the ball, over to Roback. Roback's gonna pull up. That one too strong off the back of the rim. Rebounded by St. Mary's. Kate Restovich headed the other way. Hand off to Annie. Back to Kate. Kate's gonna try the three this time. That one off the rim. Rebounded by Sampson and she puts it up. Good to go. Athena Sampson able to flash into that block to get the offensive rebound and an easy two for St. Mary's. As they're cutting into this lead a little bit now in this fourth quarter. Hope up by 19. Roback over to Guy. Over to Rea. Up top Miller. Nemmons now on that right side. She's gonna work inside. Little floater, that one too strong off the glass. Great rebound by Grayson Guy. That one unable to fall as well. Rebounded by St. Mary's. Now Annie Restovich headed the other way. Stripped by Roback. Great defense from her and hustle to get back on defense. Pass over to Rea. That one was halfway down before it popped out. Rebounded by St. Mary's. Crazy couple possessions here for both teams. Now St. Mary's races the other way again. Annie Restovich, that one I think got tipped by Lauren Nemmons. Too strong off the glass. Hope now looking to slow things down a little bit. Nemmons in the corner, back up to Roback. Over to Guy. Rea now working on the left side. Up top Miller. over to Roback. Roback drives in, able to get the layup to fall off the glass. Brooklyn Roback, her first points of the game. St. Mary's now setting up the offense. Connolly. Inside Garreau. She's going to pull up. That one a little short off the front of the rim. Rebounded by Hope. Lena Rea now setting up the offense. Lauren Nemmons drives in. A lot of contact. Trying to Eurostep. Not really sure where she was going, but nonetheless, she gets that shot to fall off the glass. Annie Restovich going to try another three. That one rattles off the rim. Offensive rebound by Connolly. Kate Restovich now going to try the three. That one unable to fall as well. So Annie Restovich came out hot for the St. Mary's team, but they've gone a little cold from three. Grayson Guy unable to connect on that layup attempt. Rebounded by St. Mary's. 67-44, 5.5 left in this fourth quarter. Restovich over to Connolly. To Garreau in the corner. That one bounces off the rim, no good. Rebound by Sampson, puts it up off the glass. Offensive rebound by Sampson and the points. And we're going to get a substitution timeout by, I believe, Hope College trying to get some fresh legs in there. So we're going to see a new five for Hope, as well as a few new faces for St. Mary's. Leach inbounds to Maynard. Back over to Leach. She works inside, kick out to Bellows. Bellows is going to try the corner triple, knocks it down. Olivia Bellows, 14 points now tonight for her. Guma now with it. Over to Schieser. In the corner, Restovich. She gets it back out top. Connolly looking at her options. That ball stripped by Hannah Kearns as Hope heads back towards the basket. Out to Brunsberg. Brunsberg almost spotted up for the triple. Decided to drive to the hole, but she's going to get called for a travel. Turnover, Hope College. Number 12, Alyssa Matuza checks back in for the Bells. Annie Restovich is going to take a rest after great start to the fourth quarter from her. Came out hot, knocked down a couple triples for this Bells team. Guma now over to Connolly. Connolly trying to find an option. Drives baseline, skip pass, over to Matuza. Matuza to Guma in the corner. She works inside a little over the shoulder floater. That one no good. Maynard comes away with it. Maynard now over to Brunsberg. Back to Maynard. Leach now on the right side. Tries to skip it over to Brunsberg. That pass hit the bottom of the backboard. Still gets its way over there. Back out to Maynard off the side of the rim. And she's going to track down her own rebound. Fresh 20 seconds on the shot clock for Hope. Bellows, corner triple try again. That one just short. Rebounded by Hannah Kearns. Maynard's now going to try the three. That one no good as well. Olivia Bellows trying to find their fourth offensive rebound in that possession, but unable to come away with it. Matuza tried to find Guma cutting into the hoop, but Brunsberg there to intercept it. Maynard now working the offense. Leach to Brunsberg in the corner. That one too strong off the back of the rim, rebounded by Lauren Leach. Out to Bellows. Maynard thought about the three, gave a little jab step, kicked it back out to Bellows. She's going to work her way inside. Bellows, a little shifty move to get that shot off the glass for two. And we're going to get another substitution timeout by head coach Brian Morehouse. So he's going to get a fresh five back into this game. Hope leads 72-46. Just over 3 minutes remain in this fourth quarter. Guma now crosses half court. Over to Matuza. That pass tipped away by Nemmons.
and she and Recker get a little tied up on that side. It's going to be a held ball. Possession arrow is going to stay with St. Mary's. Hope coming out, showing a little 2-3 zone on this possession, something a little different, thrown at St. Mary's. Porter now up off the glass. That shot unable to fall, rebounded by Lily Miller. Rhea now heading the other way. Great pass inside to Brooklyn Roback as she gets the reverse to go off the glass. Great vision there to see Roback cutting into the hoop and throw a little teardrop pass over the top. Matuza now over to Guma. Inside to Porter. Porter put the ball on the floor. That one gets bounced around. Hope comes away with it. Roback now over to Nemens. Nemens, that one no good off the glass. And we're going to get a foul on number 20, Lauren Nemens, as she was fighting to get the rebound off that missed shot. So that's going to be Hope's, either team's, first foul of the quarter, actually. It's been a quiet quarter in terms of fouls as opposed to the third quarter we just had. Guma now over on the left side. Up top to Matuza. Over to Schieser. To Guma. Guma now tries the three, knocks it down. Guma now with 5 points on the night. 74-49. 1.5 left in this fourth quarter. Guy is going to work her way inside, and she's going to draw the foul. And they're going to get number 24, Avery Schieser, on the foul. So Grayson Guy with her first free throws of the game. Guy shooting 63% from the line so far this year, only with 11 opportunities. Two more coming her way. That first one just a little too strong off the back of the rim. Second shot is up. That one banks it off the glass. Grayson Guy kind of shakes her head as she jogs back down the court. But either way, the point will count. 75-49, Hope College leads. Guma over to Matuza. Back over to Guma. Guy tries to jump that pass, knocks it away, but unable to come away with it. Three try for Recker. Or Garreau, excuse me, that one's not going to fall, rebounded by Hope. Roback now with it. Out to Nemens. She's going to try the three. That one no good. Rebounded by Guy. Offensive rebound and able to put it back in off the glass. Great possession there for Grayson Guy. Hustle underneath the hoop to work for that offensive rebound. Guma now up top. Guarded by Rhea. Gets it to Garreau. She's going to drive inside. Tries a little reverse layup off the glass and good. Her first points of the night for Mary Kate Garreau. Nemens is going to drive inside. That one good off the glass for Lauren Nemens. St. Mary's now over to Sampson. Sampson's going to try the three. That one too strong. Rebounded by Hope. Shot clock turned off. Hope's going to cross half court and just hold the ball and run this clock out. So Hope will extend their current win streak with a win tonight, 79-51 over the St. Mary's Bells. Great win by Hope College on this Wednesday night as they now head into the weekend. Update from Angola as we get ready to head out. Still 31-29, so we invite everyone to head over and watch the second half of that game of the Hope College men as they're taking on Trine from Angola, Indiana. And as we leave you with some highlights from tonight's game, Hope once again coming away victorious, 79-51. My name's Lucas Shelton. Thank you for joining us tonight for this weeknight matchup between Hope College and St. Mary's. Good night and go Hope. Holding me back, you take me
places that tear up my reputation, manipulate my decisions. Baby, there's nothing holding me back. That she's never afraid. Just picture everybody naked. She really doesn't like to wait.